We're here to save our UK travel industry, to save our businesses, and to save the jobs in the UK travel industry.
İngiltere Parlamento binasının önünde turizmciler var. Turizm sektörünün çalışanları, onların temsilcileri ki İngiltere'de 3 milyon 900 bin çalışanı temsil ediyor bu. Toplandılar ve parlamentoda toplanan hükümete, muhalefete seslerini duyurmaya çalıştılar. Diyorlar ki yeter artık, kapıları açın.
Zero income, 18 months. What are you doing?
Some of these people here, they haven't paid their mortgages, they can't afford the business loan that they had. They're having to defer that for 6 months because if there's nobody traveling, there's no income. It's been too long, so they need to listen.
Hemen belirtelim. İngiltere Türkiye'nin önemli bir turizm müşterisi. Tabii her yıl ortalama 3 milyon kişi gelir tatilini Türkiye'de yapar. Şimdi bazı acentalar var. Türkiye'ye özellikle buradan turist götüren acentalar. Bakalım onların görüşleri neymiş?
Are you sending people to Turkey, for example?
We are desperate to send people away on holiday and on business to Turkey, as well as to see friends and relatives. It's so important. The Turkish resort market, the holiday making market there is so, so important. It's still on the red list. You know, we can't send anybody there yet. So the government need to have a look and see what can be done to start opening up some of these places. Check the data.
İngiltere'nin şu an devam eden trafik ışığı sistemi benzeri derecelendirmesi, yani ülkeleri kırmızı, sarı ve yeşil liste olarak belirlemesi çok da turizmciler tarafından rağbet görmeyen bir sistem. İşe yaramadığı konusunda görüşler çok. Bu değerlendirme 3 haftada bir yineleniyor. Yani İngiltere hangi ülkenin yeşil, hangi ülkenin kırmızı olacağına 3 haftalık periyotlarla veriler ışığında yeniden değerlendiriyor.
We're really, really hopeful that any day now we should hear some positive news, and hopefully they've listened to some of our messages and understand just how vital travel is for the lifeline for the country and for the world, really. So it's really, really important to us to have those links reopened and allow trade, allow people to see their families, allow people to go on holiday, all of those good things.
At the moment, people aren't confident going to Turkey just because it has been moved to the red traffic light. But people want to go to Turkey. People have always wanted to go to Turkey. We love Turkey, but people are not confident because the PCR testing that they need to do is too expensive. You book a family to Turkey, fantastic value for money. But the PCR for a family of four, it works out to what, £1,500? Something ridiculous like that. We don't even understand why Turkey are on the red list. We absolutely don't understand this. We love Turkey.
Okay, what places you know? Tell me about Turkey.
Okay,
please.
So I myself have been to İzmir. I've been to Kalkan 3 times. I was due to go to Kalkan in June. I get the years mixed up because we've missed one. 2019, we had to cancel that. It was moved to this year and is now moved to next year. It offers such great value for money, beautiful beaches, nice friendly people,
and for English people,
people are very safe in Turkey. It offers great choice, and we love Turkey. We want the Brits, you know, they want good value for money with their holidays, and Turkey offers that. But unfortunately at the moment people need more confidence to be able to book and visit Turkey, and the only way that's going to happen is if you're downgraded to the green.
Şimdi bu 3 haftalık periyot Haziran sonu dolacak. Haziran sonu beklenti Türkiye'nin en azından kırmızıdan sarıya doğru hareket etmesi. Eğer hükümetin aşı olanlar sarı olan ülkelere de gönül rahatlığıyla gidip karantinasız dönebilirler derse o zaman Türkiye'nin de yolu açılmış olacak. Barış Çimen, Amerika'nın Sesi, Londra.